This has been an ass kicker with the fight and everything else. It's the hardest thing I've ever done.
My name is Paul Rudd, and I play Miles. The fight scene takes place in episode 8. When I first read it, I loved it. I thought, this is epic, and it will be a nightmare to shoot.
Miles has learned that new Miles has had an affair with Kate. Miles comes rushing in with an axe, ready to kill new Miles, and there's a gun there. And he thinks, is my other self a murderer? I guess I'm a murderer too. So he takes out the gun.
Are you kidding me?
Shut up.
Can you do anything right, you fucking moron?
This is such an existential comedy. Living with Yourself is about this guy, Miles, has a coworker who gives him this business card, says, go to this place. Next thing I know, I'm busting out of the ground. The spa treatment was a cloning facility, and I was the original version, and I was supposed to die, but I didn't. And so now there's two of me. You know, the finale is a guy who's trying to kill himself. He's beating himself up. More often than not, when I'm doing a scene with myself, I'm not acting with somebody. Whichever Miles is kind of driving the scene, that's the one I'm gonna film first. And so then what I will do is record the lines as I know I'm going to say them as the other guy.
I'm not telling you how to talk to. I'm just saying that you should let her talk.
I put in the earwig a line up where I have to look at the other guy. I do the scene and somebody is hitting a pad that has all the cues of the other guy's lines. I'll hear myself, I'll react to that.
What? Are you sure?
I go around and do the flip side of it. We'll play the version that we've just filmed, and I have to adjust where I'm looking at so that when I'm looking at myself, it really looks like we're looking at each other.
We're never waiting for Paul. Sometimes we're waiting for the computer, but Paul never misses. It's almost like a dancer or an athlete.
He has the timing in his head, and it's kind of remarkable.
You're such an asshole.
You have everything you need to be happy and you waste it.
We've been thinking about this scene probably the longest and on some level done the most prep for the scene because we had to.
When we first read the script, the first thing that popped out was this fight. Figuring out what that fight was going to be and working with the stunt coordinator and the performers during previs and then talking about how are we going to accomplish this.
In the fight, it is impossible to do stuff without having a double because we're moving and I need another body and we do it from two different directions.
You're the one everyone loves! Oh yeah, right!
This scene is a fight between two people who don't know how to fight. So we needed something that was, in a way, awkward and uncool.
We brought in these two brothers, the Cooperman brothers. It was just kind of uncanny that both of them actually looked a lot like Paul.
Felt like a very natural scene to choreograph for us. These guys are equally matched in strength and in instincts, and so what happens when that sort of comes together? Maybe it's this flip that happens that wouldn't happen otherwise, or a tumbling section. The sort of piggyback scene, if you will, we wanted to sort of have like a seesaw sequence. I thought it was a very apt sort of physical metaphor for the power struggle between those two.
The levels that this thing is working on is enough to drive anybody into therapy.
They're both holding a gun and their strengths are matched. It's a physical way to show, like, you cannot fight yourself. There's no end to this. It's like the snake eating its own tail, you know? Hopefully you watch that and you realize, like, oh, right, nothing good is gonna come of it. And also that fight, by the way, is based on an actual fight that I had with an actual friend. We destroyed our entire apartment, like furniture wrecked, packing peanuts. It was like, that's basically that scene was like from my life.
You ruined my life.
You ruined your life. I hate you. I am you.
Through the course of this fight, they get to a point where they're just tired, and it allows them to then recognize how much he can love himself. The show does sort of explore that idea of why is it so hard, you know, to love ourselves or live with ourselves. It's just fun to see it physicalized.
You want me out of your life? Make me. Stop it. Make me.
Stop it! Make me.
He's hating both sides of himself. The idea that that takes on this physical manifestation of two separate people as the same person and actually punching each other is hilarious and psychological.
Miles, because he's perhaps, you know, the angrier one, gets the upper hand and smothers new Miles.
Oh, God. Oh, what have I done?
I love the emotional range that they go through and violence and then understanding. I actually suffocate myself and then give myself mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. And I just started giggling when I got to that part.
We've had pretty limited time to do a lot of really complicated stuff, and I think without somebody with the skill that Paul has, it would not be possible.
Never done anything like this. I don't know how people do it. I don't know how they do it. Let's stick to movies, they're way easier.